to an all-girls school. Not that that has to be the way forward, but I went to a school, Southampton High School for Girls, very much like this one, that was very supportive and encouraging, as I'm sure you are, of my passion for science. So growing up, I loved asking questions. My favourite word was why. I was constantly asking, why does this happen? What does this mean? How does this work? I wouldn't accept anything unless someone could give me an explanation. And for me, that's what science is all about. It's not about theories or equations or whatever. It's about actually a fascination for the world, for understanding the world, for making sense of things. One of the first things I noticed was that I was one of the only girls. Now, my first thought was, well, hey, finally, you know, we get to hang out with the boys. Can we be in a little girls' school? Not just in the bottom, but right now. So yeah, I thought, great, exciting, I get to be one of the boys, I can hang out with the boys, I can hold my own, no problem. But very quickly, I actually started to lose my confidence. Now, looking back, at the time I didn't really realise what was going on. But looking back, what I realised was happening was that I was suddenly in an environment that was quite different to the sort of learning environment I'd been in. Now, I'm not telling you this to put anyone off, quite the opposite. I'm telling you this because whether you're 5, 17 or 70, you may now, in the future, in the past, be in working environments or studying environments in which you may feel a little bit different. You may feel you don't belong for whatever reason. It might be your ethnicity, it might be your sexuality, your gender. Could be anything. But in that environment, I felt a bit different. And crucially, I also felt like I was not the right kind of, not really confident enough and strong enough to be good at physics anymore. I love what you heard before about the motto to be, just be your best. And my version of that is a quote that I love, which is, whatever thy hands findeth to do, do it with thy might. So even though I was struggling, I worked really hard, I gave it my all, and I finished my PhD, and I was so proud of that. And then I went to grad school. So I spent a year training as an actress and a singer. I've spent the next 8 years working in plays and musicals across London and actually across the country. And I had a fantastic 8 years. In between times, I started working as a maths and science teacher, teaching in some local schools in London and doing some tutoring. And it's then that I realised, actually, I do love science. And actually, I am a scientist. And actually, I am cut out to be a scientist. Maybe just not, maybe I don't like the actual experiments, but actually, fundamentally, I am a scientist, and I love it. And my emotional nature is actually really helpful. And I love talking about science, explaining science. But even then, I didn't know how to bring together these two very, or seem very, disparate parts of myself. I was sort of Emily, that actress by night, and Emily, the science teacher by day. It was a little bit weird. And now, as I said at the start, 7 years down the line, I made my living being a science expert on various different TV shows, going into schools and universities, and talking about science, talking about confidence, giving talks on cutting-edge science topics. And I've just written my first book, which is called Brain Physics Facts. And it's a book for ages 7+, but it's got some fun stuff in there for grown-ups too, I promise you. And it's my baby, and I'm so proud of it. And so I'm super, super happy. I finally found something that I love doing. And I just want to end by really clarifying that what I've learned, particularly in the last 4 or 5 years, as you've heard, I was caught up in that horrible controversy about Tim Hunt. I got lots of trolling and abuse online for saying, actually, it's okay to cry. It's okay to be sensitive. And in fact, science needs those qualities. And I ended up giving a TEDx talk, which was called Why Science Needs People Who Cry. And in it, and I'd love to encourage you to go away and watch it, but in it, the take-home message, which I just want to leave you with, is that actually, as well as logic and analysis, science is about the three C's. In fact, all careers, all life is about three C's. Compassion, collaboration, and creativity. And those three C's are just as important in science as they are in everyday life. And in fact, sensitivity and emotion, authenticity, vulnerability, trying your best, being your true self, being the best you can be, and being real and true to who you are, is the entry point to being compassionate, caring deeply about your work, caring deeply about the choices that you might make in your career, in your personal life, to make a difference in the world. We have so many big problems that need solving in the world at the moment: antibiotic resistance, climate change, These need people who are compassionate, who care, who have passion and the ability to feel their emotions. They need people who can collaborate. Science particularly is a very collaborative world where you need teamwork, you need empathy, you need to be able to understand people. You don't have to, but it is a benefit. And finally, science is creative. It's about using your imagination. It's about thinking and dreaming and thinking outside the box. Einstein said, the imagination is more important than knowledge. The French mathematician Henri Poincaré said, it is by intuition we discover and by logic we prove. So, don't let anyone tell you that you're not good enough. Don't let anyone tell you that you're different or that you're weird or that you don't fit in. Whatever you're passionate about, whatever you believe in, keep going, keep doing it. It's taken me nearly 40 years to get to a place where I'm really fully fulfilled and my whole self can come to me, come to work with me every day. There's so many different careers out there. There will be so many different careers out there in the future by the time of my age. Most of those haven't even been invented yet. You might get to actually create them yourselves. So whatever you love doing, keep doing it. And whatever anyone says to you, any type of career, particularly science, can be for you. Not just even if you cry, but especially if you